All right, I'll say good day to you this day of your time. How are you all? All right. We would like to begin this transmission by reminding you that it is titled The Five Forms of Abundance. Now, there are many, many forms of abundance, but we are going to discuss five major forms that you experience in your reality in this transmission, so that you can begin to understand that it is not limited to what you may have been taught to believe is representative of abundance, of wealth, of empowerment. So, let us begin with the five forms that are most common in your world. All right, so I go back to the original question. Mm-hmm. If you do, in fact, really act on your highest excitement and be the person you prefer to be, what are you afraid might happen? That's what the panic is about. What are you afraid might happen?
It's more like things happen beyond my, you know, my imagination or my
what
capability.
Are you afraid might happen?
Let's say my roof leak, you know, when it rains or something, you know, it might
what's
pour
so
down.
Bad about that?
My house will be
is
ruined.
Is that it? If I act on my passion, my roof might leak.
No.
Oh my gosh, it's the end of my life. I'm getting water on my head. What will I do? I guess I will lie down and die.
No, I don't mean that I don't act on my passion, highest passion, because I'm worried about roof leaking. I'm talking about like my passion may be interrupted or all
did you remember what we said before about the idea that you cannot experience a negative thing if you're actually in the state of passion? The very fact that what just came out of your mouth, I'm afraid my passion will be interrupted, is exactly what I asked you to say. That's your fear-based belief. It's not a fact. It's what you believe might be true. And that's why you don't even start, because you believe in such a thing as an interruption in your passion. There doesn't have to be any such thing in your experience, but you believe there might be, so you don't even begin. So, that's the belief.
So in real life, let's say if something happens.
Real life. Because we're talking about can't possibly be real life.
No, I mean everyday life, let's say. If some dramatic thing happened, we as human, the first reaction was, oh my God, you know? And then you deal with this.
No. That's a learned response because of a meaning you're putting into the situation unconsciously. No one has to react that way. It's not automatic. It's not a fact. It's an opinion. It's a perspective. It's a belief. It feels like a fact because you're used to it. You're saying, well, everyone knows this. Everyone knows humans react. No, they don't. You've been taught to believe that they do. And therefore, for you, it's real. But it's not a fact. It's an experience you're generating because you assume it's a fact. You assume it's a natural thing. It's not. It's a learned experience.